Hello, my learner there. I'm Teacher Dishon. Welcome to my class, Standard 8 Science. We are looking at foods and nutrition. Under that, we are measuring on nutritional needs for lactating mothers. Remember, lactating mothers fall under the special groups of people. We have what we call special groups of people. We have said we have infants, we have lactating mothers, and we have expectant mothers. So for today, we are looking at the nutritional needs for lactating mothers. First of all, someone will ask you, who is a lactating mother? We are saying this: a lactating mother is a mother who has just given birth and is breastfeeding. A woman who has just given birth and is breastfeeding, that's what we call a lactating mother. Lactating mothers are also known as nursing mothers. Sometimes we call them nursing mothers. So we are saying this, their diet, remember, what you call a diet. The diet of a lactating mother should have adequate nutrients for her and for the baby. Whatever she eats should have enough nutrients for her body and for the baby. So we are saying this, her diet is composed of the following. A lactating mother should eat, number one, should eat extra fluids. Her food should contain extra fluids. She should eat food that has extra fluids. Why should she feed on extra fluids? There are two reasons. There are two reasons as to why she needs to feed on extra fluids. Number one is for formation of breast milk. Formation of breast milk. If she eats food that are rich in that has our extra fluids, number one, there will be maximum production of breast milk. Remember, she has a baby, she has a toddler who is feeding. And then number two, the other reason as to why her food should contain extra fluids is to prevent her from being dehydrated. So we are talking about to prevent her from dehydration. We are trying to prevent her from dehydration. What is dehydration? We already know that dehydration is lack of enough water in the body. Remember, after giving birth, the mother loses a lot of blood and water. So we are supposed to replace that water. So in that case, we feed her on foods that have extra fluids. Then number two, on the nutritional needs of a lactating mother, we have foods rich in iron. Foods rich in iron. Foods rich in iron. She needs a lot of iron. Why iron? Why should you feed her on enough iron? We are saying that iron is necessary for replacing the lost blood. Remember, during delivery, a lot of blood is also lost. So we need to replace that blood that was lost during delivery. So we feed her on enough irons. What are some of the sources of irons? What should she eat so as to get irons? There are very many sources of iron. So when you talk about sources of iron, you may feed her on spinach. You can give her liver. You can give her kidney. You can give her, let's say, beans, meat, and so on. These are some of the sources of iron. When you want your wife, maybe, or the mother herself, when she wants to get enough iron, then she should feed on that spinach, liver, kidney, beans, meat, etc. Remember, this iron is very necessary for replacing of the blood lost during delivery. Then the other thing that she needs is the phosphorus and calcium. Number three, when you look at the nutritional needs of a lactating mother, we have phosphorus and calcium. Phosphorus and calcium. Why do you think she needs phosphorus and calcium? Remember, we have already said that phosphorus and calcium is necessary for strong bones and teeth. So when the mother, when the lactating mother feeds on phosphorus and calcium, the milk produced will be adequate to provide strong bones and teeth for the baby. The strong bones and teeth we are talking about here is for the baby, not the mother. The mother already has strong bones and teeth, but then these ones are for the baby, strong bones and teeth. So when you want your baby to have some strong bones and teeth, you are supposed to feed on phosphorus and calcium. What are some of the sources of phosphorus and calcium? We have milk, we have cheese, we have fish, we have bone soup, we have millet, and then we have matumbo. Those are some of the sources of phosphorus and calcium. Then lastly, this mother will need proteins. Number four, she needs proteins. Proteins in this case, for a lactating mother, we are saying that proteins are very, very necessary for production of quality breast milk. When you want to have quality breast milk, then you are supposed to take foods that are rich in proteins. We all know some of the sources of proteins. We have what we call animal proteins and we have what we call plant proteins. So we are saying that for proteins, this one is for quality breast milk. Quality breast milk. And then when we talk of when we talk about some of the sources of proteins, we have what we call the animal proteins and we have plant proteins. Animal and plant proteins. Among the animal proteins, we have meat, we have pork, we have broiler, we have fish, we have termites, we have eggs, we have milk, and so on. When you talk of plant proteins, we have beans, we have njahi, we also have green grams, and we have groundnuts. Those are some of the sources of proteins. Remember, we are looking at the nutritional needs for lactating mothers. You have said that a lactating mother is a nursing mother. This is a woman who has just given birth and is breastfeeding. So her diet should contain the following: extra fluids. Number one, why extra fluids? For formation of breast milk. Then number two, she should eat enough fluids to prevent her from being dehydrated. Then number two, on her diet, she should eat foods that are rich in iron. And this iron will help in replacing blood loss during delivery. Sources of iron are spinach, liver, kidney, beans, meat, etc. Then she will also eat phosphorus and calcium, foods that are rich in phosphorus and calcium. These are actually for strong bones and teeth. Then lastly, she should eat foods that are rich in proteins. And these proteins will help in the formation of quality breast milk. Remember, we have different sources of proteins. Thank you. Welcome again. You meet me next on nutritional needs for people living with HIV and AIDS.